Welcome back to another read-along. This is going to be a real quick one because I'm going to do only going to do one chapter because my parents are in-law are out shopping and they'll be back very soon. So anyway, please open up your Bibles to chapter 7 of the book of Hebrews. Let's get started. For this Melchizedek, king of Salem, priest of the Most High God, who met Abraham, returning from the slaughter of the kings and blessed him, to whom also Abraham gave a tenth part of all, first being translated king of righteousness. Okay, and then also the king of Salem, meaning king of peace, all right? So, but Melchizedek is kind of like a Christ-like king, you know? It's a foreshadowing of Christ to come, okay? Without father, without mother, without genealogy, having neither beginning of days nor end of life, see? No mother, no father, no genealogy. But made like the Son of God, remains a priest continually. He is the Son of God. Now consider how great this man was, to whom even the patriarch Abraham gave a tenth of the spoils. And indeed, those who are of the sons of Levi who receive the priesthood have a commandment to receive tithes from the people according to the law, that is, from their brethren, though they have come from the loins of Abraham. Okay, so you see the comparison of Melchizedek and Jesus here? Okay. But he whose genealogy is not derived from the received tithes from Abraham and blessed him who had the promises. Now, beyond all contradiction, the lesser is blessed by the better. Okay? Here, mortal men receive tithes, but there he receives them, of whom it is witnessed that he lives. Even Levi, who receives tithes, paid tithes through Abraham, so to speak, for he was still in the loins of his father when Melchizedek met him. Therefore, if perfection were through the Levitical priesthood, okay, for under it the people received the law, what further need was there that another priest should rise according to the order of Melchizedek? Okay, so if we could be saved under the Mosaic law and the Levitical priesthood, you know, then we wouldn't need Jesus. But we need Jesus, okay, because the law shows us where we sin, but it fails us. We cannot be saved by the law. Okay? That's why we need Jesus. So, another priest should arise according to the order of Melchizedek, and not be called according to the order of Aaron. Okay? For the priesthood being changed of necessity, there is also change of the law. For he of whom these things are spoken belongs to another tribe, from which no man has officiated at the altar. For it is evident that our Lord arose from Judah, of which tribe Moses spoke nothing concerning priesthood. That's right, he wasn't from the priesthood. He wasn't from the lineage of Levi. And it is yet far more evident if, in the likeness of Melchizedek, there arises another priest, who has come not according to the law of the fleshly commandment, but according to the power of an endless life. For he testifies, okay, you are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek, as was discussed in the last chapter, I believe. For on the one hand, there is an annulling of the former, two chapters maybe before, annulling of the former commandment because of its weakness and unprofitableness. For the law made nothing perfect. For the law made nothing perfect. On the other hand, there is the bringing in of a better hope, through which we draw near to God. And inasmuch as he was not made priest without an oath, okay, for they have become priests without an oath, but he with an oath by him who said to him, the Lord has shown and will not relent, you are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek. Okay? By so much more, Jesus has become a surety of a better covenant. Also, there are many priests because they were prevented by death from continuing. But he, because he continues forever, has an unchangeable priesthood. Okay? He's the ultimate high priest here. Okay? And he intercedes for us in prayer to the Father. Did you know that? Did you know that Jesus is up there in heaven before his Father interceding for you? Okay? He's on his knees interceding for you. Okay? Therefore, he is also able to save to the utmost those who come to God through him. Those who come to God through him, Jesus Christ. You have to go through Jesus Christ to reach God the Father, okay? Okay? Since he always lives to make intercession for them. For such a high priest was fitting for us, who is holy, harmless, undefiled, separate from sinners, and has become higher than the heavens, who does not need daily as those high priests to offer up sacrifices, because he is the sacrifice, first for his own sins and then for the people's, for he did once for all when he offered up himself. See, that is verse 27, okay? So you should highlight those, okay, verses, chapter 7, verses 24 through 28, all right? For the law appoints as high priests men who have weaknesses, but the word of the oath which came after the law appoints the Son, who has been perfected forever. Okay, so that concludes the chapter 7 of the book of Hebrews. And I will be back later if I get the chance, the opportunity, God willing, okay? Until next time, I pray that you all are blessed in Yahshua's name. Get in your prayer closets and pray for Holy Spirit discernment. There's so much deception these days, okay? But a lot of things, okay? The only way you're going to keep yourself from being deceived is if you keep in His Word, okay? Do not listen to the voices inside your head or you're listening to your heart, because the heart is deceitfully wicked, and, you know, above all things, and who can know it? That is Jeremiah 17:9. Look it up, please. Okay? So we really need to pray for discernment. Pray to the Lord to teach Him, to teach you His voice, because it is different. You will hear other voices. Don't be deceived, okay? So until next time, I pray that you all are blessed and you pray, okay? And read His Word, okay? All right, so until next time, I'm out. Bye.